गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर स्टडीइंग चैप्टर टू कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ फूड। वी आर डूइंग द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ चैप्टर टू। वी हैव डन एक्सरसाइज ए आंसर इन डिटेल। वी हैव कंप्लीटेड क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 and 2। टुडे वी विल डू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 and 4। नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3। Children, I hope you must have completed question number 1 and 2 in your notebooks, and you must have completed your work and handed in your work in the class group. Those who have not done, they must complete their work and then send it in the WhatsApp group. Today, we are going to continue with our question answer, exercise A, answer in detail. So children, we are going to start with question number 3 today. How will you test the presence of the following nutrients? Number A is fats. So children, first we have to see what are fats. We all know that there are various components of food. Various components of food includes carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, fiber and water. So what are fats? Fats are called energy giving foods. They give much more energy than carbohydrates. So fats gives us instant energy. When we consume more carbohydrates than is required by the body, the excess carbohydrate is normally stored in the body as fats. Fats stored in the body is utilized to keep the body warm. So what are is the uses of fat? Fat is used to keep the body warm. If we take too much of fat, then we become obese. Obesity is a disease which results due to the overeating of fats. Now, what are the foods which are rich in fats? Like milk products such as butter, ghee and cheese. These are very rich in fats. Second is vegetable oils also, such as groundnut oil, coconut oil. These are also good sources of fats in our diet. Some fruits which are dry fruits like cashew nut and almond also contains fats. There are two types of fats. One which is obtained from the plant sources, and other animal fat which is obtained from the animal sources. So there are two types of fat. Number one is plant fat, which is obtained from the plant sources such as coconut oil, cashew nuts, mustard oil, groundnut and almonds. And the second one is animal fat. Animal fat is obtained from the animal products or milk products such as butter, cream, milk, eggs, fish and meat. These are the animal sources of fats. So now, to test fats in our food, we should perform the following test. What we have to do? Take a small quantity of the food item to be tested. Wrap the food item in a piece of paper and crush it. Straighten the paper. Dry the paper by keeping it in sunlight for a while. For some time, you should keep the paper in the sunlight. Now you observe the paper. An oily patch on the paper indicates the presence of fats in the tested food items. So this is a very common test for the presence of fats. This test is very simple also, and you can test it at your home also. In this test, you only required the material, that is only a piece of paper.
or white paper. You only need a white paper to perform this test. So you must try it at home. Take any food item like butter or a drop of oil, or you may take the vegetable which is cooked at your home today, and you will perform the test. So this is a picture of the test for fats. This picture is given in your book. This is figure 2.4. You have to draw this picture also. In this picture, a white paper is shown in which there is a patch of an oil, or there is an oily mark over the paper. So this shows that the food item contains oil or fat. Now the B part is starch. Test for starch. Now what is starch? Starch is a kind of carbohydrate. We have studied that carbohydrates are also energy giving compounds, which are of two types, sugars and starches. Starch is a complex carbohydrate and sugars are the simple carbohydrates. So today we have to test for the presence of starch in the food material. Foods rich in carbohydrates are potato, bread, table sugar. Table sugar is used in tea or coffee. Honey, rice, wheat, milk, jaggery and fruit like mango, banana, papaya. These are some of the items which are rich in the carbohydrates. So there are two types of carbohydrates. Number one is sugars and number second is starch. So today we will do the presence of starch test in a food item. Now what you have to do? Take a clean test tube and a little given food sample and water in it. Second point, add few drops of iodine solution in the given food sample. Shake the contents of the test tube. Observe the change in the color. There is a diagram also which shows the testing of starch. So you have to draw the diagram also. There are three test tubes in which first test tube contains food sample. In the second test tube, iodine solution is being added to the food sample. And in the third test tube, a blue black color develops. And this shows the presence of starch in the food item. So children, you have to draw this diagram on the left hand side of your notebook. And then you will color also. You will color this diagram also. Blue black color should be used in the case of third test tube. So third test tube, the color of the liquid will be blue black. So draw it very carefully, very beautifully, very neatly in your notebooks. Now we are continuing with our answer. Now next heading is observation. The color of the given food sample changes to blue black on adding iodine solution to it. And what is the conclusion or inference, children? Means what do you conclude from this test? Or what you have learned from the test? The given sample of food contains starch. Only if iodine changes its color to blue-black. Given food sample plus iodine solution is equal indicates blue-black color, means the food sample shows the presence of starch. So our answer number B is complete. We have to write this answer also, and we have to draw the diagram also which I have given you in this answer. Draw the diagram on the left hand side of your notebook and you have to write on the right hand side of your notebook. Now children, moving to our last part, that is C part, proteins. Now what is the test for proteins? It is very clearly given in your books in the form of activity 2.3. But first we will have a brief discussion about what are proteins. So what are proteins? Foods rich in proteins are often called body building foods, because proteins are needed for growth and maintenance of our body. Children, you all are in the growing stage, so your body needs more proteins to develop properly. You should include proper amount of proteins in your diet so that you can grow and develop properly. Your body grow properly. Now, proteins are also required by the body to regulate other body functions also. Proteins also protect the body from infections. Protein is also needed for the repair of body tissue. We know that our tissues are getting weird and teared every day. The tissues are worn and torn every day, and so we need proteins to repair them. So repairing of body tissues is done by the proteins. Like carbohydrates and fats, proteins can also provide energy. But it's not the case that proteins cannot provide the energy. Proteins also provide energy, but in the last case, if we are finished off our carbohydrate and fats sources of food, then our body start deriving its nutrition from proteins. This is the worst case, children. So we should include carbohydrates and fats in our food so that our body gets proper amount of energy from the carbohydrates and fats only, and protein should not be utilized from the body to derive energy. Proteins also provide energy. Now, what are the sources of protein? Protein can also be derived from plant sources as well as animal sources. Proteins from plant sources include pulses, cereals, etc. And the proteins from animal sources include milk, eggs, paneer, cheese, fish and meat are good sources of protein. Now coming to our answer, children, procedure. Take the food item in a test tube. If it is a solid item, first make it a paste of it. If you are taking a solid food item for testing, then make a paste of it. Means you add some water to it. Only 5 to 10 drops of water should be added to it. Now the next point is, shake the test tube well. Third, add 2-3 drops of copper sulfate solution and then 10 to 12 drops of sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide is also known as caustic soda solution to the test tube. Be very careful about the quantity of the chemicals which are using in this experiment or test. Only 2-3 drops of the copper sulfate solution should be used and only 10 drops of sodium hydroxide solution should be used. These solutions are easily available in the laboratory, but you should not touch them. As you are in class 6, so this experiment or test must not be performed directly by you, but it must be shown by your teacher. Now, what is the observation of this test? The color of the solution changes to purple or violet. Now, if the color of the solution changes, then it means protein is present in the food item. If the color of the solution remains unchanged, means no protein is present in the food item. So, what we have written in the inference? Protein is present in the food item. So children, what is your assignment for today? So your assignment for today is, do all the questions answer in your notebook. I hope you must have understood the topic. Okay, thank you, children.